sinned, in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, as the man who have been, all the angels and saints, and to my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O mighty Heavenly God, who assumed the immaculate Virgin and the mother of your Son, body and soul, into heavenly glory, grant you all that always attend to the things that are above, in the inheritance we share of so much glory. For Jesus Christ, your Son, who is and is with you, the image of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Book of Chronicles. David assembled all Israel in Jerusalem to bring the ark of the Lord to the place which he had prepared for it. David also called together the sons of Aaron and the Levites. The Levites bore the ark of God on their shoulders with poles, as Moses had ordained according to the word of the Lord. David commanded the chiefs of the Levites to appoint their brothers and brethren as chanters, to play on musical instruments, harps, lyres, and cymbals, to make a loud sound of rejoicing. They brought in the ark of God and set it in the tent, which David had pitched for it. Then they offered up burnt offerings and peace offerings to God. When David had finished offering up the burnt offerings and peace offerings, he blessed the people in the name of the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God my Savior. The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. For he has looked with favor on his holy servant. From this day, all generations will call me blessed. The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. The Almighty has done great things for me. I'm sorry. It's the Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. He has mercy on those who fear him and their generation. He has shown shall the strength of his arm, he has scattered the crowd and conceived. The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. He has cast down the mighty from the thrones, and has lifted up the holy. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent away empty. The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. He has come to the help of the servant Israel, for he has remembered his promise of mercy, the promise he made to all our fathers, to Abraham and his children forever. The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name.
Also happens to be our patroness. I invite all of us to thank God for the new members, 19 of them I was told, who have willingly responded to God's call into Sodality membership. Thank you for accepting to join the Sodality membership. And welcome. By accepting to join the Sodality group, you are securing for yourself a precious opportunity to practice ardent devotion, reverence, and feel your love to the Blessed Virgin Mary. To show this devotion by works of piety and zeal, by personal holiness, by helping your neighbor, and by defending and spreading the Catholic faith. This is a sure path to holiness, both for yourselves and for the people whom you influence by the way of your life and service. I would like especially to thank Diane Lopez, who has been outgoing officers, for the wonderful apostolate that they have accomplished this year, including but not limited to prayer services, feeding the homeless, collecting donations, and organizing the grand sale. However, without the close cooperation of fellow sisters and others, they would have succeeded. Every member did a tremendous job, and so I ask everyone appreciated. As for the outgoing officers, you may speak in unison with the Apostle Paul, who said, I have fought a good fight, I have finished the race. It would be a good idea if you use the experience you have gained in leadership to help new officers so that the entire Sodality group may continue to thrive. Meanwhile, I would like to congratulate the new officers for being entrusted with this small task of service. For visiting government, becoming prefect, who also happens to be my mother's son, Diana Lovell, the new vice prefect, the membership committee, and the continuing officers. Behold, as the handmaid of the Lord, be done unto me according to thy word. These last words of today's gospel defeats your response to the positions that have been entrusted to you. Our blessed mother said these words in acceptance of even greater responsibilities. By saying these words, Mary was consenting to the mystery of having to shelter the Son of the Most High in her holy womb. This mystery was a fulfillment of what we heard in the first reading from the first book of Chronicles. The Ark of the Covenant that carried the Ten Commandments was a prefiguration of man who was to carry in her womb the Word of God, that is Jesus. That's why the reason we address her as Ark of the Covenant, and she is her Savior. Now, when she was asked to give birth to the Son of God, she meekly responded, I am the handmaid of the Lord. Be done to me according to thy word. She knew that by saying so, she was endangering her life because becoming pregnant before marriage was punishable by stoning to death. But she put all her trust in God, saying, Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. Be be done to me according to the word. Threatened by Herodias, the Holy Family sought refuge in Egypt while the Son of God was still a toddler. None of us here, I think, have never experienced the tragedy of having to become a refuge. It's a tragedy. If you look at the people of Myanmar who have been forced out of their comfortable homes to the open place where there is no, you know, infrastructure, no sanitation, no what, you know, living in the open, in the poor tents. It's a tragedy. It's experience. It's a blessed man. And the Holy Father experienced. Yet she still said silently, "Behold, the handmaid of the Lord." Saying, "I'm ready to take up this responsibility, this task that you have given me, my Lord, by trusting." At one time, their own son got lost. She and her husband, Joseph, frantically searched the narrow streets and bazaars of Jerusalem, fearing for the worst of their son. Only finding in the temple, later, they certainly expected an apology from their son. But remember what he answered? He didn't know that I was supposed to be in my father's house. No, this was the last answer that a blessed mother kept her faith in God, saying, "Behold, I'm the handmaid of the Lord." And the climax of all this was a terrible experience of what we celebrate on Good Friday, the passion and death of her son. I'm trying to imagine how she was feeling when the lifeless body of her son was being handed to her from the cross. Most of us, including myself, have cast a lost all hope, but she never deviated from her original promise. Her fears, "Behold, and the handmaid of the Lord, be done to me according to the word. Let it be shown, let it be done." So, my dear new officers, you are taking upon yourself many responsibilities. They may not be as big as those of our blessed mother, but as you have accepted this responsibility right from the beginning, I've asked you to always say repeatedly, like Mary, "Behold, I'm the handmaid of the Lord." Leadership is a challenge, and it is not leadership which is easy. Leadership calls you to serve others as a servant, to influence the behavior of the people you serve, the ability to make decisive decisions, to have a clear vision, to be tough-minded, to have passion to develop the group, and the ability to innovate and create change. This is not an easy task. Sometimes the morning gets tough, and makes you feel like giving up. In such tough situations, I'll ask you to do like Mary, that is, to submit to the will of God and say, "Behold, I'm the handmaid of the Lord. Be done to me according to thy word." If you keep your gaze on Mary, she will bring all your activities to success. Because of her, that we are able to reach her son, Jesus, as the Latin saying conveys, "Per Maria ad Jesu." Mary ascended into heaven, worked of our lady of Sodality, and their mission in service of the homeless, the sick, and of the spread of the kingdom, so that by doing this, you may bring us all safely to your son in eternal joy. Amen.
Those Sodalities who wish to participate in our Sodality and those who have been approved as candidates for admission to the Sodality and who now wish to be received, may we please signify this wish by coming forward to the altar.
Reverend Father, the transferring soulless and the candidates who now ask to be received into the Sodality have been judged worthy by the Council of the Sodality of this favor. They promise to endeavor to become good members of Sodality, whose ideals and rules have been explained to them. We therefore beg you to admit them to our Sodality.
So as to make the end of all the good results and the qualifications of the transfers and candidates, we shall ask them to reply to the questions now to be asked of them.
We ask you, in the name of Sodality, whether you wish and are determined to practice an arrogant devotion, reverence, and filial love for the Blessed Virgin Mary, and to show this devotion by works of piety and zeal, by personal holiness, by helping your neighbor, and by defending and spreading the faith of the Church of Christ. We ask you in the name of Sodality whether you will practice true, unselfish, and impartial charity towards the members of this Sodality and join them in active and organized good work.
faith, hope, and love, you have expressed your willingness to capitalize over me. Receive this medal, which is a symbol of your sodality and worship. By virtue of the powers which have been given to me, I receive you in the solidarity of the Blessed Virgin. I admit you to partake in all the indulgences, privileges, and spiritual favors enjoyed by the members of the Sodality. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. by virtue of the power conferred on me as director of the Sodality, I hereby recommend that the following officers duly elected shall take office this day and shall have the duties and powers usually given such officers and as specified in our Sodality Constitution. The form is provided by the spirit and rules of the Sodality. The form is not to allow anything except serious illness from necessary work to keep you from attending the regular meetings of the Sodality and its council. We describe earnestly to further your own spiritual growth and to advance the projects and activities of the good of your neighbor and the defense of the Church of Christ.
It is with sincere goodwill that I give you, Paulette, this symbol of the office of the Prefect of the Sodality. I pray that our Divine Lord will guide you always, and that in imitation of Mary, you will draw always closer to Christ and lead our fellow souls to His Sacred Heart. Count on me to always to cooperate with you to the best of my ability.
I, Paula Daphne, do humbly accept the symbol of my office and do solemnly promise Our Lady and her Divine Son that I shall fulfill my duties to the best of my ability. I shall live up to the spirit and the rules of the Sodality of Our Lady of the Assumption, and will work earnestly to promote the aims and purposes of our society and in accordance with the wishes of our spiritual director and the will of the service. The office of Vice Prefect carries with it the splendid opportunity to work closely with the Prefect in fulfilling the Sodality rules as they are particularly set forth in our Constitution. And into your hands then, I give these two important documents so that you will know clearly the objects of our Sodality in order that you may work zealously in cooperation with our new Prefect for the advancement of Christ's cause through Mary.
I, Diana Hawthorne, accept these two documents and promise in all humility to do my best to work with our Prefect in intensifying our spiritual life, in helping to sanctify our neighbor, and in defending the Church of Christ as these are set forth in our rules and Constitution. Mine will be no great honor, but with Our Lady's help, I shall be able to fulfill our Sodality motto, to Christ through Mary.
Thank you. write this year be a solemn achievement, records that will not merely rest upon the white pages of this book, but that will be transferred by the recording angel to the book of life.
I shall remember during my term as guardian of the Sodality's funds that the money belongs to Christ and Mary. I shall try to be worthy of the responsibility for this portion of Christ's treasure upon her.
Most blessed Virgin, Mother of God and Queen of Sodality, we renew your commitment of us, most faithful in resolve, with the help of your gracious intercession, can never be worthy of the trust which has been reposed in us. To study the rules and follow them, we endeavor to encourage our fellow members to be good and worthy Sodalities. Bound by special loyalty and honor, we promote the good of the Sodality that it may be worthy of your great name. Obtain for us, most faithful Mother, the grace and fervor to carry on the work of the Sodality in accordance with the guidance of our Director. We strive to help so our Sodality in fulfilling all things, its purposes, personal sanctification, sanctification of our neighbor, and defense and spread of our holy faith for the glory of your name and that of your most holy Son. Amen.
Sanctus Dominus Deus Sabaoth.
your sacrifice and your offer to our name. Therefore, Lord, we come before you and thank you. Gracious, make all these gifts you have brought to you for consecration, that they become the body and the blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, and to some end we celebrate these mysteries. For the night was prayed, he served bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given for you.
Of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor to Alleluia. Spirits who cannot hurt, seeking your souls. Amen.